Hello diplomats, I welcome you all to this Ed Viplav Succeed Prelims 2020 Current Affairs Test Number 8 Explanation. Hope you are all doing good. So without delay, let me start the discussion session. So let us see the question number 1. The question is asking about Dehing Patkai Elephant Reserve. So it is the location it is asking. So let us see this. It is a kind of map based question as well as a current affairs related question. So if you see this map, this is about Dehing Patkai Elephant Reserve. Okay. So it is located in the state of Assam, which is near to near to Brahmaputra River. Dehing Patkai is located in Dibrugarh and Tinsukia districts of Assam. Okay. So this is the location. So as per this, the answer is A. But why it is in use, we have to have an idea. So basically, in this in this elephant reserve, recently National Board for Wildlife has given nod for coal mining, okay, in this part of this Dehing Patkai elephant reserve. But because of the wide uproar or unrest because of the agitation of local public, so recently this has been suspended. The thought of mining, coal mining in these areas have been suspended. So that is the the recent issues regarding this Dehing Patkai Elephant Reserve. Okay, so it is located in the state of Assam. Now let us look into the next question. So it is about NSS. So I think you are aware of this NSS scheme and all those things. It is started in the year 1969. So it comes under Ministry of Youth Affairs and Sports. Youth Affairs and Sports. So therefore, answer is actually option B. So actually, what is this exactly? This NSS is, let us see further about this thing. It provides opportunity to the student youth of 11th to 12th classes of schools, okay, that is at plus 12 board level, and student youth of technical institution, graduate, postgraduate. So starting from 11th 12th to technical education, graduate, postgraduates, okay, at college and university level, to take part in various government and community service activities and programs. So to take up activities in various government-led community service activities. So National Service Scheme, NSS. So why it is in use? Because recently that Foundation Day was celebrated, and they are potential. This NSS workers are potential human resources for combating COVID-19. Because they will work at community level, so they can educate people, okay, they can distribute all these sanitizers and all those, okay, so they can educate, they can counsel the people, so they can give these services, okay, to the both infected and non-infected people. So here answer is option B. Now let us see question number 3. So let us look into the question number 3. It is about coal bed methane. So I think you are all aware of this coal bed methane. So in geography, it will come across this coal bed methane is a kind of unconventional fossil fuel. It is obtained from the bedrock, that is like by mining inside into that surface, which is a kind of sedimentary fossil fuel. Okay, sedimentary rock. So within this rock, under air spaces, this gas get accumulated. So this is explored, okay, by using new techniques. Earlier it is not being focused, but recently, because of technological advancement, this fuel is also being explored from the earth surface. So if you see the first statement, it is a conventional gas extracted directly from the rock, unconventional gas extracted from the rock by removing groundwater. So this is correct. Next is the bulk of coal bed methane reserves in India are found in Shillong Plateau. So actually the bulk of CBM reserves are located in the, if you see this map, Actually, wherever the coal is located, there only the coal bed methane is also available. So, bulk of the coal reserves are located in this, what you call, the Amoder Valley. Sorry for this poor clarity, but it is like the Amoder Valley, next is Koyal Valley, Son Valley, Mahanadi Valley, Godavari Valley. So, this is the belt actually, Eastern India, okay, almost Central India and Eastern India. Eastern India is the richest source of this coal bed methane, not the Shillong Plateau. Though Shillong Plateau contains some small amount of coal fields and coal bed methane, it is not the bulk. So here the keyword is the bulk. So bulk is actually, it is present in the Gondwana sediments. Okay. So another information is, it is also known as marsh gas. Generally methane is also known as marsh gas. It is associated with coal mines. So it is called coal bed methane. So it is a kind of unconventional gas. Okay. So here only first statement is correct, second statement is wrong. Hence answer is option A. So friends, if you see the fourth question, the question is asking Aichi targets sometimes in use is related to. So if you, when while you were studying this environment aspects, I think you have definitely come across this Aichi targets. So Aichi targets come under conventional biological diversity. So this Aichi targets are biodiversity targets. So these targets were set for the period between 2011 to 2020. So there are various types of targets, that is goal A, goal B, goal C, goal D. So this you can find in the explanation part. So in the PDF and explanation PDF which you get, so you kindly just go through the brief categorization. Nothing, I mean, more details are not required, but you have to know that what are Aichi targets. Okay, so everything related to this United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change, this Earth Summit, Rio Summit is very important for prelims as well as mains. So here it is related to biodiversity. Answer is option C. So next question is about Africa, two countries, that is Sudan and Ethiopia. Okay, so Sudan is a landlocked country. So no, see, if you see this, Sudan is not a landlocked country. It got borders with Red Sea, so it is open. It is not landlocked. So first statement is wrong. Next is Ethiopia borders with Red Sea to its northeast. So if you see this, Ethiopia is the landlocked country, though it is near to the coast, but it is not open to the coast. It is not open. So it is not a land. It is a landlocked country, we can say. So both statements are wrong. Hence answer is option D. But why it is in use? Because recently Sudan, this female genital mutilation was it is ongoing practice. It is a kind of suppression of women's freedom and all those things. So it is recently, because of the agitation and all those, because of change in regime, this genital mutilation has done away with. So on this aspect, this question was framed. Okay, here answer is option D. Now let us look into the question number 6. So it is about STARS program. So STARS program was launched in collaboration with, that is with who, which support? It is actually, it's support with the World Bank. First, let us know what is this STARS. STARS is Strengthening Teaching, Learning and Results for the States program. So States program is what? So any country that is already having this educational programs, in order to support that, in order to augment that, in order to help that thing, the World Bank came up with this Strengthening Teaching, Learning and Results. Okay, that is, it is a kind of learning assessment, improving the learning assessment, learning outcomes. So more teaching models. So it will give that technical support, that financial support to these states with which it is collaborated. So recently this World Bank collaborated with Indian government, particularly 6 states, including Maharashtra. So these states will get some financial funding from the World Bank, okay, and also some support, okay, for improving this learning, student learning, outcomes, okay. So it is a 500 million Strengthening Teaching, Learning and Results for States program to improve the This is important to improve the quality and governance. So both quality and governance of school education in six Indian states. Okay, some 25 crore students in this six states. Okay, which are in 15 lakh schools. Okay, and also some 1 crore teachers will benefit from this program. So this program is recently launched. So it is very important for prelims. Answer is here. Answer is option B. That is World Bank. So if you see the question number 7, it is about National Innovation Foundation. As the name implies, it is about promoting innovation. Okay. So on this basis, three statements are given. We have to find out which are correct. It is an initiative to strengthen the grassroots technical innovations and outstanding traditional knowledge. This is correct. First let us see the information. So it is an autonomous body of the Department of Science and Technology. So it is autonomous body of the Department of Science and Technology. That is correct. It is India's national initiative to strengthen the grassroots technological innovations and outstanding traditional knowledge. Both, that is strengthening of technical innovations as well as outstanding traditional knowledge. Next is its mission is to help India become a creative and knowledge-based society. So, yes, if you see the second statement, its mission is to help India become a creative and knowledge-based society. So all statements are correct. Answer is option D. Next question is about World Drug Report. So as the name implies, it is about drugs. So recently, why it is in news? First, we'll see. United Nations Office on Drugs and Crimes has released this World Drug Report. In this, it highlighted that because of the ongoing pandemic COVID-19, so there are chances of people resorting to illicit production trade of drugs. So that this drug menace will become more rampant because of COVID-19, because of the economic crisis it created. Okay. So on this backdrop, the question was framed. So the United Nations Office on Drugs and Crimes is the United Nations Office that was established in the year 1997 as the Office for Drugs Control and Crime Prevention by combating United Nations International Drug Control Program. By combining with and Crime Prevention and Criminal Justice Division in the United Nations Office at Vienna. So it is related to United Nations only, not with the other things. Okay, hence answer is option A. Next question is about novel coronavirus, that is SARS-CoV-2. So first statement is SARS-CoV-2 has both DNA and RNA. That is wrong. So generally, what you have to know is generally the virus contains either DNA or RNA, not both. Okay. And within the DNA, there could be single stranded, that is single copy of DNA, that is single fragment of DNA, or it is a double stranded DNA. Even in the RNA also, it can be single stranded RNA, double stranded RNA. Generally, single stranded RNA, this is most common form present in most of the viruses. There are double DNA, DNA viruses also, that is double stranded DNA viruses are more common. So these are like example is hepatitis B DNA. So that is why first statement is wrong. Next statement is a room infected with SARS-CoV-2 can be disinfected by illuminating it with UVC radiation. So what is this UVC radiation? You have to know that ultraviolet radiation, actually based on the frequency, there are three types, A, B, C, N. C is like more energy. You have to remember like C is for cancer. That is generally A will penetrate to the earth surface. This ozone layer will prevent the penetration of B and C. Form of ultraviolet radiations. So this B and C, this C is more harmful, more energetic. That is more frequency. More frequency, less wavelength, and high energy. So it is, it can cause even cancers also. So this type of radiation is very harmful to coronavirus. So it can kill that. Hence, as per this, we can say that this is the same explanation given below. So as per this, second statement is correct, first statement is wrong. Hence, answer is option B. So next question is a map-based question. It is a geography-based question. So the various passes were given and their locations are given as pairs. So we have to identify which of them are, which pairs are correct or wrong. So for solving this question, I have taken these two maps. Okay, first see the Sipkila. Okay, Sipkila is located in the state of Himachal Pradesh. So in this map, okay, in this map, if you see, this is Sipkila, Sipkila Pass. Next is Jalapla. Jalapla is in this the second picture. It is in the state of Sikkim. Okay. Next is Changela. Changela is also present in the state of Himachal Pradesh only. Changla. Okay. Next Lipu Lake. Lipu Lake is in Uttarakhand. Lipu Lake is Uttarakhand. So this Sipkila, Lipu Lake are important because they are passages for Manasa Sarovar. So Manasa Sarovar Yatra. So we can go through the Sipkila or Nathula passes. So and in the context of growing tensions between India and Nepal over this Kalapan and all these issues, so this question has been framed. So there are chances of this type of questions being asked in the main exam. So here, if you see, the Sipkila is in Himachal Pradesh, not Ladakh. Jalapla is in Sikkim, that is correct. Changla is in Changla is actually in Ladakh. Sorry, Changla, it is not. So this is actually, it is above Himachal Pradesh. I'm sorry. So this Changla is in actually Ladakh region, not the Himachal Pradesh region. So that is wrong. Next is Lipu Lake. Lipu Lake is, if you see this, so distinction between Himachal and Uttarakhand. So it is Lipu Lake is in Uttarakhand. That is correct. So here 2 and 4 are correct. Hence answer is option C. Friends, let us look into the question number 11. Question is asking objectives of scheme for formalization of micro food processing industries. So this is recently proposed scheme. The cabinet approved recently the scheme. So actually, in order to promote food processing industries, we all know that many of the food processing industries are under informal category. Okay, so and food processing industry is a sunrise industry. So the rate of growth is very high, and it got huge potential in promoting doubling of farmers' income as well as ensuring nutritional security and also promoting Make in India as well as promoting exports. Okay, so in this backdrop, the cabinet approved more formalization of this micro food processing industries. So the objectives are to increase the access to finance, okay, increase revenues of target enterprises, enhance the comprehensive food quality, strengthening capacities of support system, transition from unorganized sector to formal sector, special focus on women entrepreneurs and aspirational districts, encourage waste to wealth activities, focus on minor forest protection tribal districts. So these are all the objectives. So to enhance comprehensive food quality and safety standards, that is correct. To transform the unorganized sector to formal sector, it is correct. To encourage waste to wealth activities is correct. To encourage processing of minor forest protection tribal districts is also correct. So therefore, all the statements are correct. Hence, answer is option D. So next question is also it is about an oil field, that is Baghjan oil field. So where is this Baghjan oil field located? First we have to know, okay, why it is in use and where it is located, we have to know. So that is the intention of this question. So this Baghjan oil field is located next to Maguri Bill and Dibru Saikova National Park. So it is located near this national park, Dibru Saikova National Park, and also this Maguri, okay, Maguri Motapong wetland. It is a wetland. So why it is in use also you have to know, because it is here, it contains oil fields. So for oil drilling is happening in this place, but because of this leakage and all those things, so well number 5, actually there are 22 wells, so well number 5 caught into flames on June 9th, and as a consequence of this, because of the sensitiveness in this area, pollution control board actually banned the shut down the all oil wells in this Baghjan area. That is about this this issue, this Baghjan oil field.
So Baghjan oil field is one of the oldest top. Actually, Baghjan is not the oldest. Oldest is like superlative, no? So it is the Digboi, that is the oldest oil field that is located in India. So not the Baghjan. Next is located in Dibru-Sighau National Park, Assam. It is correct. Here only second statement is correct. First statement is wrong. Hence answer is option B. Let us look into the 13th question. It is about Drug Control General of India. So this Drug Control General of India, actually we have to know the where it is, which department it is associated with. It is with Department of Central Drug Standard Control Organization of the Government of India. So under Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, there is Department of Central Drug Standard Control Organization. Okay, under this Drug Control General of India is located. So what is this DCGA function? So it is responsible for approval of licenses of specified categories of drugs such as bloods, blood products, IV fluids, vaccines and sera in India. Okay, so it comes under Ministry of Chemicals and Fertilizers. Is wrong. It approves the license to manufacture and sell COVID-19 drugs in India. So this is true because it is associated with responsible for approval or license of specified categories of drugs, vaccines also, including vaccines, okay, sera, and that is like antibodies, immunoglobulins, that is a kind of passive immunization. So here first statement is correct, second statement is wrong, and the answer is option A. Next question is about cryptojacking. So what is this cryptojacking? Let me explain this. So this question requires some kind of conceptual clarity. So first we have to know what is this. We have to know about Bitcoin process. So not only Bitcoin, cryptocurrencies. So cryptocurrencies are a kind of informal currencies, digital currencies, which are minted by some unknown groups or unknown members within the online platform. Okay, they use this blockchain technology. Okay, this blockchain technology. Suppose a Bitcoin is minted. So this Bitcoin is with person A. Now this Bitcoin will move to person B by transaction. Again, B will sell to C. C will sell to D. Okay, this transaction, this movement is being linked by means of blockchain technology. That is, so there is no scope for duplication or data ledger, change of data, like so modified or changing of data or miswritings, so wrong writings, all this can be avoided by this use of blockchain technology. So first, this Bitcoin is generated by using internet sources, by using internet and servers. Okay, so it is created online. For creating a Bitcoin, large amount of data is required, large amount of processors are required. So this miners, whoever mines or so mints this cryptocurrency, they might not be having that much hardware, okay, that much hardware to mint these coins. So they resort, what will they do is they will hack the systems of common public. So suppose this is citizen A, citizen 1, citizen 2, citizen 3. So they will creep into their system, they will use their servers, their hardware to mint that digital currency. Here there won't be any theft of data. There won't be any theft of data from these citizens, but they use their systems for minting their digital currencies, that is cryptocurrencies. As a result of which, their hardware may be damaged, and also their speed, their processor speeds, their internet speeds will be compromised. So it is also a kind of theft only. So it is known as cryptojacking. So it is a form of cyber attack, that is correct. It is a kind of cyber attack, but there won't be any theft actually. There won't be any taking of data. Okay, the technique is resorted to reduce costs associated with mining of cryptocurrency. As I said, so it is mainly to reduce the cost of printing or mining. They resort to this such crypto hijacking. What you have to know is why it is in use. So then why it is news? Because of the pandemic, the asset value has come down. Almost the economic assets have called out. Depreciation and all those things. This volatility environment has made people to go for cryptocurrencies. So the demand for cryptocurrencies is increasing day by day. This make the miners to mint more money. Okay, so because of which they are resorting to cryptojacking. This is more common for new currencies, not the established cryptocurrencies like Bitcoin. So, but some unknown cryptocurrencies, they are resorting to such thing. Okay, so here both statements are correct. Answer is option C. Next question is about Atmanirbhar Bharat. So, it is asking about objectives. Let us know the important objectives. So Prime Minister Narendra Modi said Atmanirbhar Bharat means reducing dependence on imports and saving foreign currency on imports. Next is it entails India become develop resources domestically. So it means becoming the biggest exporter of the commodities. So we should not depend on imports. We should manufacture our own goods and also we should be able to export them. So to achieve this, the PM said in each sector, each product, each service should be kept in mind and worked holistically to make India self-reliant. Okay, so reducing dependence on imports and saving foreign currency reserves is the objective. It is an isolationist strategy to make India self-reliant. So though the objective is to make self-reliant, but it is not, our intention is not to become isolationist. Okay, so self-reliance in this sense is neither exclusionary nor isolationist. Actually, we want to help the world also. So earlier this we have solved this problem. That is in the data in the internet world. So this 2000, beginning of 2000, that 00 issues that we have helped in solving. And also, our campaigns against open defecation, tuberculosis and polio also, it has actually have a positive impact in the world. So in the same way, Atmanirbhar Bharat is also will have that positive repercussions in the world. So it's not like a isolationist strategy or it is an exclusionary strategy. Okay. So here only first statement is correct, hence answer is option A. If you see the 16th question, it is about global initiative against transnational organized crime. So transnational organized crime, the globe, what is this about? So it is actually international non-governmental organization headquartered in Geneva. So it is not an agency of the United Nations. Next is, the global initiative comprises a network of over 500 independent global and regional experts working on human rights. So human rights, democracy, governance, developmental issues, where organized crime has become increasingly pertinent. Okay. Next, the global initiative provides a platform to promote greater debate and innovative approaches as the building blocks to an inclusive global strategy against organized crime. So it is mainly to combat this organized crime. Okay, it is an non-governmental organization. So it is an NGO. It is not related to governments and it is not an agency. So it is a platform that promotes inclusive global strategy against organized crime is correct. Here second statement is only correct. Answer is option B. Friends, if you see this 17th question, it is about NDMA Act. So if you see the NDMA Act, the Government of India on 23rd December 2005 enacted this act, which envisages the creation of NDMA and SDMAs. So NDMAs are headed by Prime Minister, not by Home Minister, and SDMAs are headed by the Chief Minister, not the Chief Secretaries. So both statements are wrong, hence answer is option D. It's an easy question. I think you have answered this question correct. Next question is about small island developing states. So this SIDS, okay, what is the SIDS? So SIDS are islands of the Caribbean Sea, Atlantic, Indian and Pacific Oceans. So not only Oceania, even the islands which are surrounding other oceans, okay. They are group of small island countries that tend to share similar sustainable development challenges, including small but growing populations, limited resources, remoteness, susceptible to natural disasters, vulnerable to external shocks, excessive dependence on international trade, fragile environments, fragile environments, etc. So these are having this common development, common issues. Okay, so based on this, this grouping is done. This is it. So this group of small and island countries tend to share similar ecosystem development challenges. This is correct. Next is the SIDS were recognized as a distinct group of developing countries at the United Nations Conference on Environment and Development. So it is being recognized in United Nations Conference on Environment and Development, that is the ET Summit in 1992, not the United Nations Climate Change Conference Paris, that is 1915. Okay, this is not at that time. This is in 1992 only. So first statement is correct, second statement is wrong, hence answer is option A. If you look into the 19th question, the question is asking about manufacture, storage and import of hazardous chemical rules 1989. So why the question is asked? Because recently we all know that in the city of Visakhapatnam in Andhra Pradesh, because of this leakage in the factory, leakage in the chemical factory, almost 20 to 30 people almost were killed, and many thousands of people were affected by this gas leak. Okay, so on this backdrop this question was framed. So the main, if you see this, the this manufacture, storage, import of hazardous chemicals 1989 was firstly enacted in 1989 by Ministry of Environment and Forests. Okay, that is MOEF. It is not related to Ministry of Chemicals and Fertilizers. And later amended in 1994 and 2000, it regulates the manufacture, storage and import of hazardous chemicals in India. The transport of hazardous chemicals must meet the provisions of Motor Vehicles Act 1980. So transport of hazardous vehicles is related to the Motor Vehicles Act, whereas the manufacture, storage and import are related to the Ministry of Environment and Forest. Okay, so here its main objective is this rule is to prevent chemical from industrial activities, chemical accident from industrial activities. So first statement is correct, as you have seen. Second statement is wrong, hence answer is option A. This question is very important, okay, because it is related to environment and also it is very recently in news. Next question is about partial credit guarantee scheme. So we have seen in the earlier test we have seen about this partial credit guarantee scheme. So in order, in the backdrop of this slowdown of economy and also this COVID-19 pandemic created economic crisis, so the government has resorted to more support by partial credit guarantee scheme. So the what is this partial credit guarantee scheme? So what is this? So actually this non-banking financial companies, housing finance companies and also some other microfinance institutions, they are not able to survive. So they are not performing well. So they are actually resorting to issue of bonds for raising resources. So this issue of bonds will be purchased by various entities. So the government is actually, in order to promote the purchase of bonds, so particularly this PSBs and PSUs and PSBs, etc. So mainly PSBs. So this the government is giving this credit guarantee up to 10% credit guarantee. Okay, this credit guarantee it is giving, the government is giving credit guarantee to these PSBs. Okay, this is known as partial. So it is only about 10% and it is credit guarantee. So it is partial credit guarantee scheme. So first it was issued in the year 2019, that is December 2019, offering sovereign guarantees up to 10% of the first loss to PSBs. So it is mainly related to PSBs, not other things. So mainly PSBs, okay, for purchasing pooled assets worth rated BBB or above, the BBB plus or above, okay, worth up to 1 lakh crore from financially sound non-banking financial institutions, okay, and also multi-finance institutions. So The outbreak of COVID-19, this is the recent development. The outbreak with lockdown of business activity has now necessitated adoption of additional measures to support NBFCs and HFCs on the liability side by providing a sovereign guarantee to cover purchase of bonds or CPs issued by NBFCs, HFCs, as well as microfinance institutions, which should also play a critical role in extending credit to small borrowers. And on the asset side, by modifying the existing PCGs to widen its coverage. So it is covering non-banking financial institutions, microfinance institutions, housing finance companies. So all are correct, hence answer is option D. Next question, it is about proposed expansion of G7. So recently, USA has proposed the increasing G7 membership to G11 by including various countries like India, Russia, South Korea, Australia, and not China. So actually, it is a strategy proposed by USA to counter China. It is to counter China. So China is not included in the list. The potential members are India, Russia, South Korea, and Australia. So here 1, 2, 3, 4 are correct. Hence, answer is option B. So the intention is mainly to avoid China because of its aggressive policy, international pursuits, okay, political pursuits, this Hong Kong issue, Taiwan issue, and all those things. So this is a proposal of USA. Okay, the answer is option B. Now let us look into the 22nd question. It is also about COVID-19. So the government may have taken various measures to tackle COVID-19. In this aspect, it has given three things and asked about which of them are part of COVID-19. Management or measures, initiatives taken by the government. So one is Arogya Setu. So I think everyone is aware of this Arogya Setu. Arogya Setu is a mobile-based app launched by the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. It is mainly about knowing people. It is informing people about one is a health education point of view, and also it will tell how close they were with the COVID positive patients. So it will not only educate people, and it will alarm people about the risks they have exposed to. So Arogya Setu is definitely related to COVID-19. C-Vigil is not related to the COVID. It is actually launched by Election Commission of India. It is an online platform. It is a mobile-based thing. So it will enable people to report violations of Moral Code of Conduct, that is MCC. Next is Ayush Sanjeevani. Ayush Sanjeevani is launched by Department of Ayush, Ministry of Ayush. So this is also an app actually. So it will intend to generate data on usage of this Ayush advocacies and measures among population and its impact on prevention of COVID-19. So by this data will help in to find out the usage of Ayush interventions and its efficacy and maintaining health by enhancing immunity. So how far this Ayush form of medicines will help in improving the immunity and also helping in educating the people. So that will be studied by this data generated through this app. So here 1 and 3 are related to this COVID-19. Hence answer is option C. If you look into the 23rd question, it is about World Health Assembly. So basically, this June month and May and June are mainly the current affairs are all related to this COVID thing only. So the questions here, the more number of questions will be related to COVID-19. Okay. So here the question is about World Health Assembly. So World Health Assembly is the decision-making body of WHO. Okay. It is attended by delegations from all WHO member states and focused on a specific health agenda prepared by the executive board. The main functions of the World Health Assembly are to determine the policies of the organization, appoint the director general, supervise financial policies, and this is all the general activities they do. It is the world's highest health policy setting body and is composed of health ministers. The health assembly is headed annually in Geneva. So it is headed by health minister from member states. That is correct. So here both statements are correct and the answer is option C. If you look at the 24th question, it is asking about difference between vaccination and inoculation. So inoculation is a old form. So though the objective, the purpose is same, that is what generally it is about. So whenever a virus or a bacterium or any other pathogen enters into body, what will happen is it will trigger immunity, immune response, because of which the body will develop some antibodies, as well as it will develop some cell-mediated immunity. So because of this, it will combat that particular virus, it will kill that virus. So whenever again the same virus enters into the body, because of this memory, the virus or bacteria will be easily killed by this immunity response. So this is the basic concept lying under this immunization. So if you instead of giving the normal virus, if you give this killed virus or any weakened live virus or any subproduct of the virus or bacterium, okay, then it is known as vaccination. So this got that antigenic properties. So if you give this virus into the human body, the same immune response will be there, and so body will develop antibodies for that infection. That is known as vaccination. But earlier, Edward Jenner, at the time of smallpox, okay, what this scientist did is, earlier there was no concept about this weakened virus, killed virus. So actually he directly inoculated this smallpox virus into the normal individual. This inoculation is there will be any weakening or any killing of virus. So live virus is directly injected into the body. So as a result of which, the person will develop all the symptoms. Here in the vaccination, there won't be any symptoms. Generally, there won't be any symptoms. So here and due to inoculation, the chance of death of the patient is also there. Okay. So the patient will suffer. Okay. So only if the patient recovers, then he will get that immunity. Okay. So that is the difference between inoculation and vaccination. Inoculation is a old practice. Vaccination is the latest practice. So vaccination is less risky, more safe, more effective. Okay. That is the difference. Vaccination predated inoculation. So actually inoculation predated vaccination. Okay. Inoculation is less risky. No, inoculation is more risky when compared to vaccination. Here both statements are wrong. Hence answer is option D. Next question is about Chak Hau is a famous product of Manipur, which was awarded GI status. Okay. It is actually a black rice variety. So I have taken this picture. So this is black rice. Okay. This is the actually unhusked form. This is the sweet, the traditional sweet they made with this black rice. So it is related to Manipur. It is a scented glutinous rice. Okay, cultivated in Manipur. It is characterized by special aroma. It is eaten during community feast and is served as chako kheer. Chako has been used by traditional medical practitioners as a part of traditional medicine. So it has been recently given GI tag. So that is all about this question, and the answer is option C. So let us see question number 26. The question has given some events in the life events in the Buddha, and asked which of them have happened on the day of Vesak. Okay, so Vesak is an important day, an auspicious day in the religion of Buddhism. So actually Vesak is related to the day on which actually Buddha was born, and it is also the day where Buddha it is the same day on which Buddha got enlightenment, and it is the same day on which Buddha was expired. It was on the same day he passed away. So that is the thing. Here answer is option D, that is all the statements are correct. Now let us look into question number 27. So it is also related to Buddha. Okay, so question is asking which of the following places were associated with life of Buddha. So earlier we have seen various important events related to Vesak, and now various places which are related with the life of Buddha. Okay, so if you see, this is Kapilavastu. It is actually the place where Buddha was born. Sarnath, it is the place where Buddha gave first sermon after enlightenment. Avanti is actually not related to the associated Buddha. And Kusinagara, yes, Kusinagara is the place where Buddha got obtained Mahaparinirvana or the death. Okay, so these three, that is 1 to 4, are related to the associated with the life of Buddha. Hence, it answer is 1 to 4. So, this is basically a culture related event, a culture related question, but it is often, I mean, this is on the day of Vesak celebration. So, on this basis, the question was asked. Next, let us see question number 28. So, question is asking, under Article 54 of the Constitution, the President is elected by an electoral college which comprises of. So, if you see the Article 54, so the President is elected not directly by the people, but the members of electoral college comprising of elected members of House of Parliament, elected members of the Legislative Assembly of the states, and elected members of the Legislative Assemblies of Union Territory of Delhi and Puducherry. Okay, so it is only elected members, not the nominated members. So first statement is wrong. Second statement, elected members of Legislative Assembly of the states, that is correct. Third statement, elected members of the Legislative Assemblies of the Union Territories of Delhi and Puducherry, it is correct. But actually, the question is asked based on this thing only. So, a student filed an RTI to Election Commission of India to know whether Jammu and Kashmir Electoral College is included for electing the president. So, for that, Election Commission recently gave the reply that it is as per Article 54. So, at present, the Article 54 comprised of only Legislative Assemblies of Union Territories of Delhi and Puducherry, but not the Jammu and Kashmir. So, as of now, you have to take that only second statement is correct, the entire third statement is wrong, only Delhi and Puducherry are correct. Hence, third statement is totally wrong, only half correct, only second statement is correct. Hence, answer is option B. So, this is very important question. So, it is related to current affairs. So, you should know, you should be aware of this development. Next question is based on this open market sales scheme. So you should not confuse with open market operations. Okay, open market operations are related to economy, that is the money raising thing. Open market sale is related to agricultural aspects, that is mainly selling of food grains when there is scarcity in the market. Okay, so it is a scheme aimed at enhancing the supply of grains to moderate the general open market prices, especially during the lean season. Government sells the grains at prices lower than the procurement cost, but much higher than the issue prices under PDS. So generally, the government will purchase the grains from market by MSP, then it will be stored by FCI Food Corporation of India, then it will be distributed to various districts, then the fair price of it will be selling through MSP. So MSP is very less rate. This is actual procurement price, not MS. This is the actual price at the fair price shops. Okay, fair price shops. This is MSP, procurement price. This is nothing but procurement price. So procurement price, Food Corporation of India, maintenance charges and all those things also will be there, and the price that is under PDS is very less, but through open market sales, so the price will be more than that of the procurement but less than that of the PDS price. So let us see the first statement. It is a scheme aimed at enhancing the supply of grains in the market. Correct. The government agencies sell the grains in open market at prices equal to the issue prices under PDS. No, it is less than the issue price under PDS, but more than that of the procurement price. So, only first statement is correct, and the answer is option A. If you see the question number 30, it is about convalescent plasma treatment. Okay. So, let us see the first statement. Blood plasma contains red cells and white blood cells. Actually, you should know that. So this is a test tube. So if you pour some blood into this, and if you allow it settle allow it to settle. Then after a few minutes, what will happen is, so this RBC will settle down. RBC, WBC will settle down, and this a fluid will be there. Straw colored fluid will be there. This is actually serum. Okay. So if you add some anti-clotting agents, then if you allow the same things to settle down, then you will also see this, the red blood cells, white blood cells and platelets will deposit in the bottom, but here in the top of it will be like a yellow color fluid. This is serum. So both are to some extent similar, but this is plasma. Okay, plasma. So this top liquid, actually they also contains clotting factors in the case of plasma. In the case of serum, because of the the clotting factors are used up for clotting the blood. So in the serum, no clotting factors will be present. No clotting factors. Whereas in the plasma, clotting factors will be present. So that is the major difference. Blood plasma contains red blood cells and white blood cells. No. Plasma don't contain this thing. Blood serum and blood plasma are same. Both are not exactly same. Blood plasma is generally generated from blood followed by centrifugation technique. This is correct. So plasma is obtained by centrifugation technique. Here only third statement is correct. Hence answer is option B. Hope I am clear. Now let us look at the 31st question. The question is about Ayushman Bharat. So we have discussed it many times in the earlier tests. So Ayushman Bharat is a comprehensive health insurance scheme. This comprises of two things. One is health and wellness centers, that is primary care will be provided. Next is Jan Arogya Abhiyan. This is a health insurance scheme. It provides secondary tertiary care services. Jan Suraksha Yojana. So it is tertiary and comprehensive secondary tertiary care services will be provided. So health card will be issued. More than 10 crore people will be benefited. Okay. So 10 crore families. So almost like 50 crore people will be benefited. So these are all the basic components of Ayushman Bharat. So it is a comprehensive need-based healthcare service, correct. It provides care for about 5 lakhs per family per year for second and tertiary care hospitalization. This is also correct. Okay. One of its limitation is that registered beneficiaries would get treatment only in the place where they are registered. This is wrong. It is actually pan-India scheme. So any person can be registered anywhere and he can get services. Not only that place, but also the other areas as well. So second, third statement is wrong, but first and second statements are correct. Hence, answer is option C. So regarding Ayushman Bharat, we should be better knowing the information. So Ayushman Bharat is very important. Next is it has given this question. Some places were given and asking which of the following above are in the unit territory of Ladakh. Okay. So first is Pangong So Lake is actually it is in the Union Territory. So this is not given the question. So first we have to see the other things. So Galwan Valley is actually present in the Ladakh only. This is the Galwan face off point. Why it is in news? I think everybody is aware of the thing, of the recent standoff between India and China over this region. Okay, so Galwan Valley is invariably in the Ladakh region. Nakula is actually located in the Sikkim, so it is not related to Ladakh. And Hot Spring Gogra area, yes, the Hot Springs Gogra region is also in the Union Territory of Ladakh. So here Gogra area as well as Galwan Valley are located in the Ladakh, but not the Nakula. Nakula is located in Sikkim, hence here answer is option C. Now let us move to the 33rd question. This is also related to COVID-19. So N95 mask. So N95. N is about non-oil components. It is a mask, you right? So this mask will actually protect from the non-oil components, not the oil components. So that is about this non-oil component. That is N component deals with This is a respirator rating letter class. It stands for non-oil, meaning that if no oil-based particulars are present, then you can use this mask in the work environment. So it is about non-oil, whereas 95 represents it is 95% efficient. That is, it will purify the air up to 95%. It will purify the air up to 95%. Whereas 100 marks purify up to 99.97%. So it removes 99.9. It is wrong. It is only removes up to 95%. It can be used in an environment where oil particles are present there. This is also wrong. Where oil particles are not present. So here none of the statements are correct. Hence answer is option D. Let us see the question number 34. The question is asking about Gavi. So we have to know what is this Gavi. Gavi Alliance is actually related to, it is related to Global Alliance for Vaccines and Immunization. So it is a global health partnership of public and private sector organization. It is not an intergovernmental organization. It includes both governmental and public as well as private sector organizations. So the primary goal of the organization is to improve access to immunization in poor countries. So Global Alliance for Vaccines and Immunization, as the name implies, it is mainly related to immunization things. So Gavi brings together developing country and donor governments, the World Health Organization, UNICEF, the World Bank, the vaccine industry in both industrialized and developing countries, research and technical agencies, civil society, the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation, and other private philanthropies, to improve the access to immunization in poor countries. Here, second statement is correct, first statement is wrong. Therefore, answer is option B. Let us look into the 35 question. It is about helicopter money. So, aftermath of this COVID related financial crisis and this slowdown of economy, chief ministers of some states have recommended for helicopter money. So we have to know what is this helicopter money. So helicopter money is what? It is an unconventional monetary policy where central bank provides non-repayable money to the government. So RBI in the case of India will mint money and give it to government. So government will distribute the money to the public for various welfare activities and all those. So the purpose is to stimulate economy, to stimulate the demand. So people, the money will be there with people, they start buying something so that the economic activity will be boosted. So the monetary policy is used to increase the consumer expenditure. That is correct. It is an unconventional monetary policy where central bank provides non-repayable money to the government. That is also correct. So it is coined by actually Friedman. Okay. So here both statements are correct and the answer is option C. Next is about question number 36. So it is asking about tundra biome. So tundra biome, the biome is found in Arctic and Antarctic regions of found only. So it is not like that. So tundra region is, of course, if you see that biomes, yes, this tundra biome is located in this higher latitudes, but even the case of lower latitudes in the higher altitude regions, so ice line, above the line of ice line, so this tundra climate will be present. Okay, for example, this Himalayan regions, Karakoram regions, Andes, Alps, etc. So this tundra biome is present. So it is only, here the keyword is only, though that's why it is wrong. It is characterized by vegetation composed of grasses, mosses, and lichens. This is correct. So it is a geography based question. So climatology, I think you have all done, you have correctly marked this question. Next, look into the 36th question. We have seen 36. So let us see 37th question. So it is about which of the following rivers originate in Kalapan in the Himalayas. So it is the Kali River. So if you see this map, this is a disputed region, Kalapani, between India and the Nepal. So here the Kali River is originating. So the Sharda River or the Kali River and Mahakali also originates in the Kalapan in the Himalayas at an elevation of 3600 meters in the Pitorgarh district in Uttarakhand. It flows along Nepal's western border with India and has a basin of 14,871 kilometers. It joins Ghagra River, a tributary of Ganges. This is also important. So as an extension to this question, some statement will be given. So it is a Kalapani is a tributary of Ghagra River. which is again a tributary of river Ganges. So here it is Sharda. So Sharda, instead of Kali, they have given Sharda. So don't get confused, both are the same. Now let us look into the question number 38. So which of the following app launched by the government of India to facilitate single point of access for citizens to all government services? So single point of access for citizens to all government services, it is nothing but Umang app. So Umang is unified mobile application. So as the name implies, unified mobile application for new age governance is one of the key initiatives under Digital India program to develop a common unified platform and mobile app to facilitate single point of access to all government services. It is envisaged to act as a master application which integrate major government services like agriculture, education, health, housing, etc. The application will enable users to access e-government services from the central government, the state governments, local bodies and their agencies. So both horizontal and vertical, okay? So various departments at each level and both central, state and local bodies, all government services will be access at a single point, that is through Umang app. So and answer is option D. So if you see the 39th question, it is about ultraviolet radiation. I think we have seen this regard discussion about ultraviolet radiation. UV radiation comprises of mainly three categories, UVA, UB and UVC. So if you go from A to C, the frequency will increase, the energy will increase, but the wavelength will decrease. Okay, so C is more energetic and it will kill all the germs, and also it is actually carcinogenic, that is it is cancer causing. Okay, to this extent we have seen. Here we'll see further. Actually there is a term called far UVC radiation. So what is this far UVC? Far UVC light, actually it is the range between 207 to 222. Recent studies reveal that this far UVC light efficiently kills pathogens potentially without harm to exposed human tissues. Whereas normal UVC, it is actually typically the range is about 254 nanometers, that is more free. Okay, it is more, I mean, but the problem is it's effective in this context. If it used directly, can be health hazard to skin and eyes. So that's why this far UVC light is actually more healthier. I mean, it won't cause damage to the humans, but it can kill all pathogens. So that is why various experiments have revealed that far UVC radiation is not more harmful, it is less harmful to humans. Okay, next, UVC is harmful to humans than UV radiation. This is true. First statement is true. As I said, it is C is more energetic form, so it can cause more harm, whereas far UV radiation is less harmful to humans. Here only first statement is correct, second statement is wrong. Answer is option A. Next question is about new orientation for a reformed multilateral system, NORMS. It is seen in news. Actually, it is related to affairs of United Nations. Okay, United Nations. So India is actually is seeking for permanent membership in United Nations Security Council. So in this backdrop, it is telling that India's overall objective during this tenure in the United Nations Security Council will be achievement of norms. United Nations Security Council comprises of both permanent members and non-permanent members. So we are trying for a permanent membership, but as of now we are having a non-permanent membership. So while this in this tenure, our Indian government tells its objectives. Okay, so through External Affairs Jay Shankar, India expressed its objectives. Okay, objectives in this United Nations. So its objective is during this tenure in the United Nations Security will be achievement of norms, new orientation for a reformed multilateral system. So it wants to establish a multilateral system, not the bilateral, trilateral system, bipolar or tripolar political system in the world. Okay, and also he proclaimed that there are, guided by 5 S's. So India's approach will be guided by 5 S's. Those are Samman, Samvad, Sahyog, Shanti, okay, to create conditions for universal samriddhi, prosperity. So for universal prosperity, India should, work on the India's approach should be guided by these things: respect, dialogue, cooperation, peace. Okay, so it is related to the affairs of United Nations. Answer is option C. Next question is about dexamethasone. dexamethasone is in use because of the COVID-19 crisis. So experiments in countries like UK has revealed that dexamethasone in critically ill patients will improve the, especially on the ventilator patients and all those, will improve the outcomes, life outcomes. So dexamethasone, we have to know about dexamethasone. It is a steroid. So it is a steroid. It is giving in life-threatening conditions. It will help in reducing the inflammatory response. It will modulate the inflammatory response. It will prevent the leakage of fluid into the lungs. So in this way, it will helpful for managing this COVID-19 related pathological damage. So it is an Indian government approved steroid for reducing mortality in patients with severe COVID-19. That is correct. It is a part of National List of Essential Medicine. Though actually dexamethasone steroid, it has got various applications. So it is given in terms of, sometimes in case of pregnancy, it will be given as ointment in some skin related infections. Okay, so various other conditions this dexamethasone has advised. So it is there in the National List of Essential Medicines. So both statements are correct. Hence answer is option C. So this is another question. It is an academy based question. It is a simple question. India is a member of which are the foreign initiatives? So I think everyone knows that India is not a part of Belt and Road Initiative. By this only you can eliminate two options. And I think you are now, India is the part of BRICS Development Bank, that is BRICS New Development Bank, and also Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank. So 1 and 3 are correct. Hence answer is option B. So friends, if you see the 43rd question, it is about non-aligned summit. So Indian Prime Minister has recently participated in the online summit. Now in the backdrop of COVID-19, now the it is all about e-diplomacy. Okay, it is all about e-meetings, e-diplomacy. All the meetings are going through online, video conferencing and all those things. So in this backdrop, some statements are given about NAM. So NAM is a non-alignment movement. It is not an organization. It is a movement. Okay, mainly it was done to avoid these bureaucratic hurdles. Next is Ghana is one of the founding members of the NAM, non-aligned movement. It is also correct. India did not attend any NAM summit after the collapse of USSR. This is wrong. So even recently, India has participated in various NAM summits. So the question has asked not correct. Now it is about not correct. This, mind you, so it is asked about which of the statements are not correct. So not corrected statements is only 3. So NAM is not an organization is correct. Ghana is founding member is correct. Only third statement is wrong. So it is asked about wrong statement. That is answer is option B. Now let us look into the 44th question. It is about Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan. Okay. So we have also discussed about Atmanirbhar Bharat in earlier test and also in this test also. So it is a first statement. It is a special economic and comprehensive package of 2 lakh crore. 2 lakh crore. It is not 2 lakh crore. It is 20 lakh crore, which comprises of 10% of GDP. So it is 20 lakh crore, which is equivalent to almost 10% of GDP. Its aim is to make India a self-reliant global economic powerhouse. That is correct. So second statement is correct. First statement is wrong. Hence answer is option B. Let us look into the 45th question. It has given various states and asked which of them share land border with China. So in the backdrop of this China-India standoff, this question was framed. If you see carefully, this is Ladakh. So this is a previous map. So this is all about, this is entire Ladakh, Himachal Pradesh. So Himachal Pradesh is there, Ladakh is there. Even Uttarakhand is there, Uttaranchal is there, but Uttar Pradesh and Bihar are not there because it is Nepal. They are bordering with Nepal, not China. So Uttar Pradesh you have to remove. Sikkim, yes, Sikkim is there. Arunachal Pradesh is also there. You have to remove. You have to discard third one. That is Uttar Pradesh. And also Ladakh is there. So you have to include Ladakh. So then the answer would be 1, 2, 4, 5. So the answer is C. So it is a map. We completely a map based question. So it is very, very important question. So it has got immense potential to be asked in the main examination. Next question is about India-UN Development Partnership Fund. So United Nations Development Partnership Fund is mainly
It is mainly the fund project portfolio aims to contribute to the efforts of developing countries towards the realization of 2030 agenda for sustainable development. So it is a it is established in 27 as an ambitious agenda of promoting multilateralism and shared prosperity. So promoting multilateralism and shared prosperity, it is the aim of this fund. And the other importance of this is to fulfill this 2013 agenda for sustainable development. And in this India UN Development Partnership Fund is managed by United Nations Office for South-South Cooperation. Okay, it is a wing of United Nations, so it is not by World Bank. So in the second statement, as we have seen, it is correct. Here only second statement is correct, first statement is wrong. Okay, therefore answer is option B. Now let us look into the 47th question. It is about National Productivity Council. We have to know what is this National Productivity Council. National Productivity Council is established in the year 1958. It is an autonomous organization under Department of for Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade. So first statement itself, it is stating that it is an autonomous organization, so it is a correct. It is a not-profit organization established under Society Registration Act 1860. This is also correct. Okay, so it is a non-profit organization, autonomous multi-partite organization. NPC provides consultants and training services to both public and private sector organizations, also correct. This is also correct. So as per the given question, all statements are correct, hence answer is option D. Now let us look into the question number 48. So it is about styrene. Recent, I think why it is asked, you all are aware of that. So in recently in Visakhapatnam, so because of this styrene leakage, many people were killed and hospitalized. So it is a chemical leakage from the LG polymers factory in Visakhapatnam. So it is a derivative of benzene. Yes, styrene is a obtained from benzene ring only. It is a derivative of benzene ring only. Next is styrene in its gaseous form is exposed can affect central nervous system. This is also correct. As per the medical expert, this is correct. Next is polystyrene. It is a polymer derived from styrene useful in the manufacturing of microwaves, computers and food packaging minerals. So actually styrene is a main raw material for synthesis of polystyrene. So from styrene, polystyrene is obtained. So polystyrene has got various applications like parts, applications like manufacturing of various appliances like computers, food packaging, copolymers, etc. Here all statements are correct, hence answer is option D. Let us look into the 49th question. It is about Rajya Sabha. Okay, first statement is the election is held in accordance with the system of proportional representation by means of a single transferable vote. That is correct. The seats are allocated to the states based on the geographical size. No, it is based on the population. It is based on the population. Geographical size is not a criteria. Next, one third of its members retire every second year. This is correct. So I think that's why it is called a permanent house. Okay, second statement you can eliminate. So the only option left is option C. So answer is option C. Next question, it is about comprehensive strategic partnership, CPS. So why it is asked? Recently in a e-summit between India and Australia, so both countries agreed to raise the partnership to comprehensive strategic to the level of CSP. So that is the recent development. Okay, so on this diagram the question is given. So we have already got CSP ties with United Arab Emirates and Vietnam. With the recent development, that is in the June 2020, so Australia has been elevated to the CSP status. Hence here answer is option D. We got the CSP relationship with all the given countries, that is UAE, Australia, and Vietnam. Okay, along with that we also got CSP with United Kingdom and Indonesia. So question in this aspect also can be asked in the main examination. Let us look into question number 51. It is about vaccination. Okay, in the aftermath of this COVID-19 and the ongoing vaccine trials, so this question is framed. So the first statement is, first vaccine to be administered in India was for contagious disease of smallpox. Okay, next is, so for this explanation, The first dose of smallpox vaccine lymph in India arrived in May 1802. So that is correct. The first vaccine to be administered in India was for contagious disease of smallpox only. So it arrived in May 1802. Okay, so Anna Dutschel, a 3-year-old child from Bombay, became the first person in India to receive smallpox vaccine in the same year. Next statement. Though smallpox is a prevalent disease in many sub-Saharan countries, India is a WHO declared smallpox free country. Actually, this is wrong, because smallpox is actually eradicated. The last naturally occurring case was diagnosed in October 1977 in the entire world. The World Health Organization certified that global eradication. So there is no smallpox case now. So as per the given statement, the smallpox is prevalent in many sub-Saharan countries is wrong. Therefore, only first statement is correct. Answer is option A. Let us look into the question number 52. So it is asking about river Bharatpuzha and other rivers in Kerala. It is only westward flowing river in Kerala. This is wrong, because if you see this picture, so there are about 44 major rivers in Kerala. Out of them, 41 are west flowing. That means major rivers in the Kerala are originating in Western Ghats and flowing towards Arabian Sea. So first statement is wrong. Next, Bharatpuzha river, it flows through Palghat Gap and empties into the Lakshadweep Sea. So this is correct actually. So okay, this is a correct statement, this could not be shown in this map because of this lack of clarity. So the second statement is, it should be considered as correct thing. First statement is wrong. So here only option B is correct answer. So this is also about rivers. So the question is asking, which of the following is known as Sara of Bengal? So it is actually the Damodar River. If you see this map, this is the Damodar River basin. This is the Barkar River, the tributary. So it is around Chotanagpur Plateau. Okay, the Barkar is its main tributary. So it is the West Bengal area. This Damodar River causes excess flooding in this region because of the Damodar Valley project. The floods have come down. So Kosi is the actual Sara of Bihar, not Bengal. Here answer is option D. Next question is about National Institutional Ranking Framework. It is the initiative of Ministry of HRD, not the Niti Aayog. Okay, it is the HRD Ministry's initiative. It was launched in the year 2015. So the parameters that were taken are teaching and learning, so resources, research and professional practices, graduation outcomes, outreach and inclusivity, and perception. So it is a framework that outlines methodology to rank educational institutions, okay, across the country. First statement is correct, hence answer is option A. Next question is about which of the following actions can be taken by the government to realize self-reliance in the economy, that is Atmanirbhar. So investing in education and skill building will help promote human capital, so that will help in the building of economy, that is self-reliance. Rationalization of taxes, yes, tax broadening of tax base, decreasing tax burden, that is decreasing tax rates also, it will promote industries to some extent. So it will, and also it will promote spending, and it will boost the economy. Next, providing quality infrastructure is also one of the important, especially in the logistics area. So it will boost the economy. But encouraging freebies will divert the resources for short-term needs. So it will actually decrease the goal of self-reliance. So only 1, 3, 4 are correct. Hence, answer is option B. Let us look into the question number 56. So it is talking about labor laws. In India, all labor laws can be exempted in the event of public emergency, including laws related to child labor. It is wrong. So yeah, in emergencies, labor laws can be suspended. For example, the industries could be shut down for a short span of time, or the salaries, etc., can be curtailed to some extent during the national emergency or any other emergencies. So power to exempt during public emergency will promote that, but not the child labor. So the child labor laws cannot be exempted during the emergencies. Okay. Next is, changes to the labor laws brought in by state government require union government assent. Yes, that is correct. So as per this, the second statement is correct. First statement is wrong. Only answer option B is the right answer.
Next question is about Sustainable Development Goals. The concept of SDGs was first born in United Nations Conference on Sustainable Development, that is Rio at Summit. The concept of was born in that Rio Summit, that is correct. Next is the SDGs were adopted with the United Nations Resolution 2015. Yes. So in order to keep bring that into force, these were adopted in the United Nations through United Nations Resolution the 2015. This is also a correct statement. Both statements are correct. Hence, answer is option C. If you look into the question number 58, it is about NDRF, that is National Disaster Response Force, and also the State Disaster Response Force as well as State Disaster Response Fund. So NDRF should respond to both natural and man-made disasters. That is correct. State Disaster Response Force should be also participate in community capacity building and awareness generation program within the state. That is also correct. Okay. And the third statement is the central government contributes 90% of the State Disaster Response Fund allocation for all states and territories. This is wrong. The central government contributes 75% of SDRF allocation for general category states and 90%. This 90% is only for special category status states and UTs only. The annual central contribution is released in two installments as per the recommendation of the Finance Commission. So as per these, both one and two statements are correct. Third statement is wrong. Hence, answer is option A. Next question is about it is a matching pairs are given, that is about volcano and the location of the country, and we have to choose the correct pairs. So actually, why these are asked? Because all the volcanoes became active in the years 2019 and 2020, they were active eruptions. So Anak Krakatau is the child of Krakatau only, that is, it is located in Indonesia, not Philippines. Okay, that is why first pair is wrong. Taal volcano is located in Philippines, not Indonesia. Merapi volcano is also located in Indonesia, not Japan. So here all the given pairs are wrong, hence none of them is correct. If you look into the 60th question, it is about Global Partnership for Artificial Intelligence. So this is, what is this Global Partnership for Artificial Intelligence? In the year June 2020, that is recently, India joined the League of Leading Economies in including USA, UK, EU, Australia, Canada, France, Germany, etc. Okay, to launch the Global Partnership on Artificial Intelligence. India has become the founding member of the initiative. So India is a founding member. Next, it is an international initiative to guide the responsible development and use of artificial intelligence. So it is an international multi-stakeholder initiative to guide the responsible development and use of artificial intelligence grounded in human rights, inclusion, diversity, innovation, and economic growth. So therefore, both statements are correct. Hence, answer is option C. Let us look into the 61 question. It is about the reverse transcriptase polymerase chain reaction, that is real-time RT-PCR. So this question is framed in the aftermath of COVID-19. So the confirmative test for COVID-19 as of now is RT-PCR-19. So real-time polymerase, reverse transcription polymerase chain reaction. What is this? Let us see. So polymerase chain reaction is mainly a technique which is used for detecting the DNA. Viral genetic material. It could be DNA or RNA. So in the case of COVID, it is the RNA. Okay, it is a nuclear derived method of detecting the presence of specific genetic material in any pathogen. That is correct. So this technique will actually identifies a fragment of specific DNA or RNA in a given sample. Okay, so it will match with, so it, already the information about particular virus will be there, the DNA genetic material, and the sample will be taken. So they will be overlapped and see whether they both match or not. So if they match, then it is confirmed that it belong to particular virus. It is the diagnosis of Zika virus. Yes, obviously, even not only Zika virus, Ebola virus also, and now COVID-19. So for confirmation, this RT-PCR is being used. So both statements are correct. Hence, answer is option C. Let us look into the 62nd question. It is also about COVID-19. So with reference to contract tracing in times of COVID, and consider the following statements. So Aarogya Setu app, which helps in self-evaluating one's risk of exposure to COVID-19, works on the novel concept of syndromic mapping. Okay, this is correct. Okay, anyone can view the source code of Arogya Setu app without any authentication. So this is also correct. That is, if you say the Arogya Setu app, so what will it contain? So first you have to give information, self-declaration of information you have to give, and also you have to access to location and all those you have to give. Okay, then you will be provided access, like how much risk you are exposed. Okay, how much risk you are exposed, and also various information regarding the health, education, and all those things, precautions that you'll be taken, all will be provided in this map. So it helps in self-evaluating risk of exposure to COVID-19. Okay, and this is a syndromic mapping only. That is, it will take into lab information, the GPS of other people information, all this will be clubbed together and that will be mapped. Anyone can view the source code of Arogya Setu app without any authentication. So source code can be accessed. So everyone can install this Arogya Setu app and everybody can access this app. So here both statements are correct, hence the answer is option C. Let us look into the 63rd question. It is about Nature Index 2020. Okay. So it is, this ranking is related to, okay. So who will give this thing? Okay, so it is actually Nature Research. What is this Nature Research? Nature Research is a division of the International Scientific Publishing Company, the Springer Nature. Okay, Springer Nature is a British German academic publishing company. So it is a division of that company that publishes academic journals, magazines, online databases, and services in science and medicine. Okay, next is as per this report, three of the autonomous institutions of the Department of Science and Technology, Government of India, have found their place among the top 30 Indian institutions as per Nature Index. Okay, based on research published in the top journals as a measure of research quality. So it is all about nature. Okay, it is the measures taken. Okay, for promoting research. Okay, regarding this. Nature conservation and all those things. Okay, so here answer is option B. Now let us look into the question number 64. It is about Indian elephant. So it is listed in the appendix 1 of the conservation on international trade in endangered species of flora and fauna, that is CITES. So yes, it is included in the appendix 1 of the CITES. It is listed in the schedule 1. Yes, it is also listed in the schedule 1. So both statements are correct. Okay, and the answer is option C. So our further information is, it occurs in 16 of the 28 states in the country, and it is showing an increasing trend. So it is actually showing an increasing trend. The question can be given like there is a decreasing trend. If it is decreasing trend, that is wrong. Okay. Now let us look into the 65th question. This is a very interesting question. Questions like this were asked in the year 2018. So now, similarly, the question was framed. Okay. So this is all about artificial intelligence. So, artificial intelligence refers to the simulation of human intelligence in machines that are programmed to think like humans and mimic their actions. The term may also be applied to any machine that exhibits traits associated with human mind. So suppose if you feel sleepy while driving, your car sets in auto drive mode. So actually the automatically driving automatic vehicles and all those use artificial intelligence. Okay, recommendations of more toys for, okay, all this is related to artificial intelligence only. So answer is option C. Next is Limpi Adhura, often mentioned in news, is related to the affairs of, so it is actually related to the affairs of India and Nepal. So it is a Limpidura. Actually, there is a pass. Okay, Limpidura pass in Uttarakhand being claimed by Nepal by constitutionally changing the map of Nepal. So it is claimed by Nepal as its territory. Okay, so it is related to the affairs of India and Nepal. Let us look into the question number 67. It is about emergency credit line guarantee scheme. What is this emergency credit line guarantee scheme? So the scheme actually, it aims at mitigating the economic distress. So so as a part of Atmanirbhar Bharat only, so because of this lockdown situation, the MSMEs were worst affected. In order to revive the MSMEs, the government has asked the banks to provide lending facilities to the MSMEs liberally. Okay, so this the government will give guarantee for this MSME loans. So the scheme aims at mitigating the economic distress faced by MSMEs by providing them additional funding of up to 3 lakh crore in the form of a fully guaranteed emergency credit line. The main objective of the scheme is to provide incentive to the member lending institutions, that is banks, financial institutions, non-banking financial companies, to increase access to and enable availability of additional funding facility to MS borrowers. So parties are banks are parties, NBFCs are party, MSME borrowers are also parties to this. So here all of them are correct, hence answer is option D. Now let us look into the 68th question. So it is about Asiatic Lions. Asiatic Lions, okay, is actually listed in the Schedule 1 of the Constitution, that is correct. It is listed as an endangered animal in the correct, it is also correct. The population of the Asiatic Lions dwindled over past years is wrong. Actually, the recent census, Asia's exclusive population indicates numbers have risen, okay, by 29% over 5 years. Okay, the State Forest Department of Gujarat says that the population is 674, including males, females, and cubs. During 2015, that is 5 years ago, the baseline was 523 lions. Okay, so the Asiatic lion population has increased. So here only 1 and 2 statements are correct. Hence, the answer is option A. Next question is, with reference to dairy and animal husbandry sector promotion, consider the following statements. Okay, so dairy infrastructure investment development fund was set up for incentivizing the investment by cooperative sector. So in order to promote cooperative sector's investment, this dairy infrastructure development scheme was set up, fund was set up. But later it was realized that not only the cooperative sector, even the private companies and individual entrepreneurs have to be promoted for incentivizing these investments in this animal dairy and animal husbandry sector. So that's why the other fund was set up, that is Animal Husbandry Infrastructure Development Fund. So Animal Husbandry Infrastructure Development was set up for incentivizing investment by private companies and individual players, whereas Dairy Infrastructure Fund is set up for incentivizing investment by cooperative sector. So the statements were wrongly given, crisscrossly given. So here both statements are wrong. That is, answer is option D. Next question is about National Institute of Virology. It is an autonomous body under the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. It is autonomous body under the ICMR, Indian Council of Medical Research, not directly under Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. NIV, National Institute of Virus, is a national monitoring center for influenza, measles and coronavirus. So this is correct. So it will monitor all the vaccine, this influenza, measles and coronavirus are all viral diseases only, na? So these are viruses. So, they will be studied by NIV only. Here answer is, second statement is correct. Answer is option B. Now let us look into the 71st question. The question is asking about the cyclones. Okay, the tropical cyclones that occur during the monsoon period are steered into India by easterly jet stream. Okay, it is easterly jet stream. That is why first statement is wrong. The southeast region of India do not receive monsoon rainfall at all. So this is southeast means. Okay, this is south and southeastern this region. Okay, this region, and it depends upon frequent cyclonic outburst and rainfall. This is wrong actually. The southeast region of India receives rainfall during the winter months from northeast monsoon. So the states of Tamil Nadu, state of even Andhra Pradesh, so they receive northeast monsoon rainfall from northeast monsoons also. So therefore second statement is also wrong. This is a NCERT based question. So NCERT based question, it is a fundamental question. Next question is about global organization and their headquarters. Why it is asked? Because recently the USA is resorting to this isolationistic and protectionist tendencies, where it is gradually coming out of various international organizations. So especially it is increasing in the election year. Okay, so Trump, because of
his protectionistic and isolationist policies, he is trying to come out of various international organizations. So we are witnessing a process of deglobalization. So there, in this backdrop, the question is framed. WTO organization, okay, that is located in Geneva, that is correct. International Industrial Development Organization, it is promoting industrial development, it is present in Vienna, this is also a right statement. NATO, actually North Atlantic Treaty Organization, it is a military cooperation among especially the Western Bloc country that is formed post World War. This is the location is located, the headquarters is located in Brussels. So here all of the statements are correct, hence answer is option D. Next, let us look into the 73rd question. It is about various enterprises and the annual turnover limit that should be there. Okay, so if you see, I mean, why it is in news, because recently in the month of June, the finance minister has updated this thing. So the definition, it has increased the investment turnover up to 50. It has made up to 250. So this is the recent development. So micro, that is up to 1 crore. For small, it is up to 50 crores. The turnover should be like up to 50 crores. For medium, it is up to 250 crores. So for medium, they have increased recently from 100 to 250. So the medium is correct. The micro and small are wrong. Hence, the answer is option B. Okay, this is as per the revised definitions of MSME, that is in the month of June 2020. So this is the development. Based on this, the question was framed. So if you see the 74th question, it is about Sweet Revolution. Sweet Revolution is an initiative of the Government of India, James said. So Sweet Revolution is like to promote beekeeping and increase the honey production to double the farmer's income. So sweet is, I mean, honey is sweet, right? So it is related to honey promotion and all those things. Okay, in encourage research in food processing, supply of sufficient water nutrients to incentivize chocolate, that is all wrong. So it is about beekeeping, promotion of honey cultivation and honey production. Okay, beekeeping and all those things. Next question is about immunoglobulins. So immunoglobulin G antibodies start, IgG antibodies start appearing in a person's body soon after he get infected SARS-CoV-2 virus. Soon, this is wrong. Okay, not immediately. They will be developed as an immune response to the SARS-CoV-2 virus. And sometimes it may not be formed also. If the virus is very aggressive, by the time the antibodies are produced, it can kill the human being. Next is to detect IgG antibodies, ICMR is indigenously developed IgG ELISA kit. This is correct. So this ELISA kit government has, ICMR has developed. This will help in to know whether the person has already been infected, whether the person has already been infected and recovered from COVID test or not. Okay, sorry, COVID virus or not. So here only first statement is wrong, second statement is correct. So only option B is the right answer. Let us look into question number 76. So here it is about the farmer produce, selling of farmers produce and the reforms that are being taken up recently. So what is the current affairs in news? So recently the cabinet have approved the Farming Produce Trade and Commerce Ordinance 2020. Okay, so this has been approved to form this ordinance. Okay, so the ordinance will create an ecosystem where the farmers and traders will enjoy freedom of choice of sale and purchase of agri produce. So the farmers as well as the traders can buy and sell produce. Okay, it will also promote barrier free interstate and intrastate trade of commerce outside the physical premises of markets. Next, this is a historic step in unlocking the vastly regulated agriculture markets in the country. So as we are know that this agriculture produce is regulated by APMC Act, where the farmers can sell their produce only at certain places and to only some registered individuals. So it will curtail the right to freedom of the farmers to sell their produce. Okay. So in the farm gate marketing, a farmer sells his agriculture produce directly to the consumer. This is correct. Okay. Next, farmers in India should sell their produce only to registered licenses of the state governments within specified. This was earlier, this was correct in the earlier scenario, but after this ordinates, there won't be such thing. So farmers can sell to any person. Here only first statement is correct. So farm gate marketing will become a reality with this ordinance. So answer is option A. If you look into the 77th question, it is about law officers of India, that is attorney generals. Okay, attorney general. So article 76 of the Indian Constitution has provided for the office of attorney general and solicitor general. This is wrong. Only attorney general has been mentioned in the Constitution, not solicitor general. Attorney general is a government servant of India. No, it is not a government. He is not a government servant of India. Only he is appointed by the government and he can give advices to the government. He will represent government in the the judiciary, and he is not a government servant at all. Okay, here both statements are wrong. Hence, answer is option D. Okay, so only attorney general's office is created. Article 76 does not mention about solicitor general. Attorney general does not fall in the category of government servants. So answer is option D. Let us look into the 78th question. So which are the following rights which appeared in news during COVID-19 lockdown? These are the rights appeared in the COVID-19 lockdown. Which of the above rights fall under Article 21? So actually 21 is the right to life and personal liberty. In the Supreme Court, over a period of time has diversified the Article 21, and various things have been included under Article 21, which includes right to privacy, right to health, right against inhuman treatment, right to travel abroad, etc. So all the given things are part of Article 21. Okay, so these are to some extent affected because of this COVID-19 lockdown. Answer is option D. Now let us look into the 79th question. It is about decarbonizing transport in emerging economies project. So what is this project? So Niti Aayog and the International Transport Forum ITF of OECD, Organization of Economic Cooperation and Development, jointly launched the decarbonizing transport in emerging economies, okay, DTE project in India on 24 June 2020. So this is a recent development. It was set up jointly by Niti Aayog and International Transport Forum of the OECD. It is a mission mode project to eliminate all diesel vehicles. This is wrong. The aim is not to eliminate completely, but it is an ambitious 5-year project will help India develop a pathway towards low carbon transport system through development of modeling tools and policy scenarios. So there is no aim like to completely eliminate all diesel vehicles. So only it is aim is to towards a low carbon transport, not like complete zero carbon. Okay, so here only first statement is correct, and the answer is option A. Let us look into the 80th question. It is about ELISA test. So ELISA test can be prescribed. What is this ELISA? ELISA is enzyme linked immunosorbent assay. Why it is done? It is done to detect some antibodies. Okay, detects and measures antibody levels in your blood. This test can be used to determine if you have antibodies related to certain infectious conditions. So yes, it can be done to detect various viruses, the antibodies. Okay, so in the human body, here it can be done for anything. Hence, answer is option D. Next question is about counter-cyclical capital buffer. So what is this counter-cyclical capital buffer? Actually, it states that whenever the economy is running in good condition, so the banks has to set up more amount of money as a buffer for the against the loans they give. And in times of crisis, they have to spend. There is a liberal provision so that the Basel norms can be relaxed to some extent. Okay, that is about counter cyclical capital buffer. But so let us see the statements. It is a Basel III norm under which banks should set aside a portion of their capital to deal with distress situations. That is correct. Okay, to deal with distress situations, so that capital should be kept aside. It is being implemented in India and monitored by the Reserve Bank of India. Actually, in India, the RBI not suggested this CCP on banks from 2015 because they don't have capital buffer to draw on. But not activating it now can help banks keep up the credit flow in the economy. So if you impose this thing, so banks cannot be able to give more amount to enterprises. That means, so there won't be any flow into the economy, money flow into the credit flow into the economy. So in order to promote credit flow into the economy, the RBI has not initiated this move. So it is not being implemented by Reserve Bank of India as of now. So only first statement is correct. Hence, answer is option A. Now let us look into the 82nd question. It is about Indian Bison. It is an environment-based question. Indian Bison is also known as Indian Boar. So it is listed as critically endangered animal. It is not a critically endangered animal. It is only a vulnerable animal. Okay. And distribution. Nilgiri Hills is the only habitat. No. It is located in the Western Ghats, Central India, Eastern Himalayas, and also the other countries like Myanmar, Bangladesh, Indonesia, etc. So it is native not only to India but also South and Southeast Asia. Gaur occurred throughout the mainland of South and Southeast Asia. So here both statements are wrong, hence answer is option D. Now let us look into the 83rd question. It is about International Labour Organization Conventions 9743. So these are related to migrant workers. So Migration for Employment Convention, that is revised, that is a Convention 97, and Migrant Workers Convention 1975, which is Convention 143. So both are related to the migrant workers. So their safety stand, their safety, their rights, their decent treatment, all are covered under these two sections. Under conventions 1997 and 143. So these are related to migrant workers. Friends, let us look into the 84th question. So the question is about Pradhan Mantri Bharatiya Jan Aushadi. So Jan Aushadi is medicine, right? So it is about generic medicine, promotion of generic medicines, and so selling of generic medicines at the retail out by setting up retail outlets in various parts across the country. It is implemented by Ministry of Chemicals and Fertilizers, Department of Pharmaceuticals, which comes under Ministry of Chemicals and Fertilizers, to provide quality medicines at affordable prices to the masses. The first statement is correct, second statement is wrong. So Pradhan Mantri Bharatiya Jan Aushadhi Pariyojana stores have been set up to provide generic drugs which are available at lesser prices but are equal in quality and efficacy as expensive branded drugs. So here only first statement is correct, hence the answer is option A. Now let us look into the 85th question. Kaveri is a near perennial river. That is correct. Why it is called near perennial river? Because upper catchment area, if you see this course of Kaveri, so it arises in the Tal Kaveri in Brahmagiri Hills. So that is in Karnataka. It will flow down to Tamil Nadu. It will open into the Bay of Bengal. So since the upper catchment receives rainfall from the southwest monsoon and the lower catchment receives from the northeast monsoon, so it is like the flow, water flow will be like throughout the year. So it is a near perennial river. Kaveri River rises in Tal Kaveri and Brahmagiri Hills in the Eastern Ghats. Now it is in the Western Ghats in Karnataka. The Kaveri Water Management Authority is an independent executive body which does not work under any ministries. Not the center has set up this Kaveri Management Authority and it has brought under the Ministry of Jal Shakti. It is not working under a ministry. Okay, so here only one statement is correct, hence answer is option A. The next question is also about River Kaveri. So it is asking which are the following are tributaries of Kaveri. So Kaveri is a peninsular river which is originating in Western Ghats and flowing towards east and opening into the Bay of Bengal. The important tributaries are Harangi, Hemavati, Kabini, Suvarnavati, Bhavani and Amravati. So Kabini, Hemavati, Amravati are correct. Indravati is a tributary of Godavari River, not Kaveri River. So 4 is wrong. 1 to 3 is correct, hence answer is option A. So in this map you can see all the things. Sorry for the lack of clarity of this picture, but you can Google it and you can find the river ports of Kaveri and its tributaries, right bank tributaries as well as left bank tributaries. Let us look into the 87th question. It is about PM Swanidhi. Okay, what is this thing? So Swanidhi is PM Street Vendors Atmanirbhar Nidhi. PM Swanidhi, a special microcredit facility for street vendors. In order to promote the economic viability or economic self-reliance of the street vendors, Pradhanamantri Street Vendors Atmanirbhar Nidhi has been set up, okay, by decision of the government. Okay, a memorandum of understanding has been signed between Ministry of Housing. So it is set up by Ministry of Home Affairs with the Small Industry Development Bank of India. Okay, so it is a special micro credit facility for street vendors. That is correct. So SIDBI implements the scheme under Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. So that is also correct. So this is a recent development. So the SPM Swanidhi has been set up in order to promote these street vendors. Okay. Now let us look into the question number 88. It is about Biological Weapons Convention. So biological weapons. So why it is asked? There is a suspicion that even this coronavirus is a kind of biological weapon. So we have to know about this Biological Weapons Convention. That is the only convention that is available for biological weapons. So Biological Weapons Convention was opened for signature in the 1970 and was enforced in the year 1975. Okay, India is also signed and ratified the treaty. This is correct. So it is the first multilateral disarmament treaty banning an entire category of biological weapons. That is also correct. It prohibits the development, stockpiling and use of toxin weapons. So this is the first multilateral disarmament treaty banning an entire category of weapons. Okay. So prohibits the development, production and acquisition of, transfer, retention, stockpile, use of biological and toxin weapons. So that is also correct. So hence here all statements are correct. Answer is option D. Let us look into question number 89. So it is about polity, different types of polity. Residential form of system is better at holding government to account. It is wrong. Okay. Parliamentary system provides a higher level of stability. That is also wrong. Actually, it is the vice versa. That is, they are wrong, I mean, crossly given. So presidential form of system, which is followed in USA, which is, it provides more stability. Okay. And the accountability of the government is less in the case of USA, whereas in the case of parliamentary system, which is followed in India, here the holding of government, holding of the government to accountability, holding accountability of the government is where there is better in parliamentary system, but the stability is less because of the changing of parties and the passing of no confidence motion and all those things. So here both statements are wrong, and the answer is option D. Let us look into the 90th question. It is about right to freedom of speech and expression guaranteed under Article 19. So the right can be used only against the state action. So in these two statements, this right can be used only against the state action. That is correct. So if the state wants to, I mean, the state tries to curtail the freedom of speech and expression, so yes, the aggrieved person can seek the judiciary for enjoying his right. Okay, first statement is correct. Next statement is about, first statement is correct. Okay, the aggrieved person can approach constitution for enjoying his right. The first statement is correct. Next statement is, this right is also applicable to foreigners. No, actually 15, 16, 19, 29, 30 are exclusively, they are applicable, I mean, they are enjoyed by the Indian citizens only. So this is not applicable in the case of foreigners. Only first statement is correct. Second statement is wrong. Hence answer is option A. Now let us look into the 91st question. So the question is about Swadesh. So let us know about what is this Swadesh. Swadesh is a skilled workers arrival database for employment support. So in the aftermath of this COVID-19, the government of India has been, it is helping to come back of the foreign NRIs. Okay. So they are, it is helping the people to come back to the India. So by Vande Bharat mission. So mission Vande Bharat. It has been almost like 3 to 4 months since the mission has begun. So now the government has started taking measures in order to boost their skills so that their employability can be improved and they can get decent employment opportunities in India. Okay, the government of India has launched a new initiative, Swadesh, to conduct a skill mapping exercises of the returning citizens under the Vande Bharat mission. The aim is to make the best of our skilled workforce returning to the country due to the ongoing pandemic. This is a joint initiative of the Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship, Ministry of Civil Aviation, Ministry of External Affairs, which aims to create a database of qualified citizens based on their skill sets and experience to tap into and fulfill the demand of Indian and foreign companies. So it is a skill mapping exercise of the returning citizens from overseas. Hence, answer is option B. Now let us look into the question number 92. It is about various lakes. Okay, so these are located in Jammu and Kashmir. The question is asking which of the following are saltwater lakes and which are, saltwater lakes we have to identify. So famous lakes in Kashmir, Himalayas are freshwater lakes are Dal and Ular. So Dal and Ular are freshwater lakes, not the saltwater lakes. Saltwater lakes in this area is Pangong So and So Moriri. So Moriri and Pangong So are saltwater lakes. So here only 2 and 3 are correct. Hence answer is option D. Next question, it is a kind of pairs given. One is a portal and the associated ministry. So first is about Champions Portal. So Champions Portal is about what? The Champions Portal is about assisting Indian MSMEs, micro, small, medium enterprises, march into big league as national and global champions. So it is an initiative of the Ministry of Micro and Small Medium Enterprises to leverage the capacities of MSMEs by using modern ICT tools. Okay. Next is TILIP. TILIP stands for the Urban Learning Internship Program. So the Urban Learning Internship Program is a joint venture between Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs and the All India Council for Technical Education. Okay. So it is mainly to encourage students to learn about this urban learning, the problems in urban areas, the problems related to housing and all other issues. So it is about this TULIP portal. Okay, actually it is TILIP. Okay, TULIP. Okay, the urban learning. Sorry, TULIP. So the urban learning. So here in the explanation, it was written like TILIP. It is actually TULIP. Okay, next is Satyabhama portal. So Satyabhama portal was launched by Ministry of Coal, Mines and Parliamentary Affairs, that is Ministry of Mines also. So it is launched by the Honorable Minister. So okay, it is mainly for Science and Technology Program Scheme for Ministry of Mines. Okay, Science and Technology Yojana for Atmanirbhar Bharat in Mining Advancement. Okay, so the postal, it is designed, developed and implemented by the National Informatics Center. So it is developed in the aftermath of this COVID pandemic only. So it is promoting the mines related development. Okay, so mining, in the areas of mining, science and technology program, okay, scheme has been developed. So that is about Satyabhama portal. So all the statements are correct, hence answer is option D. All the matches pairs are correct, hence answer is option D. Now let us look into the 94th question. So it is about bats. So bats, so why this question is asked? Because so there is a hypothesis that the recent coronavirus, that is COVID-19, which is caused by novel coronavirus, it is obtained from bats also. Bats. Okay, so in this backdrop, this bats, the information related to bats is to be known by civil service aspirant. So for this, that's why this question is framed. So they are source of food for many people around the globe. Yes, many people in South Asia, they depend on bats. Okay, I mean they eat bats. They help in conserving biodiversity. Yes, because they depend on nectar. Okay, they eat nectar. They act as agents of pollination. Okay, and seed dispersal, fruit dispersal. So in that way, they help in conservation of biodiversity, to help in farmers in controlling pests also. They help in increasing forest cover also. So like seed, by disposal of seeds, and also by killing, by what do you call, by promoting pollination and all those things, it will help in farmers also, it will help on the biodiversity. So all the above statements, given statements are correct as per regarding bats. So answer is option D. Now let us look into the question number 95. It is about Project Earth Ganga. Okay, so Earth is kind of economy, that is money related. So Project Earth Ganga, it is related to Ganga River. So the main intention is energizing the economic activity along the Ganga River bank. That is the intention of this thing. So in the recently conducted Ganga Council meeting, National Ganga Council meeting, the Prime Minister has envisioned for this Project Earth Ganga in order to boost the economic activity. Economic activity along the river Ganges, this has been set up. So under this, it envisages that to re-engineer the Jalmarg Vikas project, that is the inland promotion of inland waterways. Okay, which is Ganga River is also part of this thing. By involving the local community, the focus on economic activities in and around Ganga River. Small jetties along the Ganga to boost the economic activities at the community level would be set up as a part of Project Ardh Ganga to energize economic activity along river banks in Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Jharkhand and West Bengal. So it is about energizing economic activity along the Ganga River bank by setting up small jetties. So let us look into the question number 96. It is about various pressure belts and the winds. Okay, various winds because of these pressure belts. So it is asking about roaring 40s. Okay. So this roaring 40s and all those are actually their westerlies. They are westerlies. Okay. So they will be present in both northern and southern hemisphere. Okay. The trade winds in both northern and southern hemisphere are known as roaring 40. These are not actually trade winds. These are westerlies. Okay. They blow from subtropical high pressure regions to the subpolar low pressure regions. That is correct. So this is subtropical high. This is subpolar low. This is polar high. This is equatorial low. So they flow from subtropical high to subpolar low. Okay. The direction is from southwest to the northeast in the southwest to the northeast. So yes, the direction is from southwest to northeast. So that is also correct. So both 2 and 3 are correct. Okay. So westerlies in both hemispheres are known as with various names such as roaring 40s, that is in around 40 degrees, furious 50s, that is a 50 degree latitude, and shrieking 60s in 60 degrees latitude. In both hemispheres, westerlies blow from subtropical high pressure regions to the subpolar low pressure regions of the globe. So both 2 and 3 statements are correct, hence answer is option B. Now let us look into the 97th question. So a burgeoning locust swarm in Rajasthan, Gujarat and even parts of Madhya Pradesh threatened to amplify into an agrarian disaster. Yes, we have seen locust attacks in the North India recently. So in this light, consider the following statements. The first statement, it is for the first time that India is facing the problem of locust swarms. No, this is wrong. So if you have seen the previous test discussion, we have seen about locust attacks. So it is there since British times. So they have set up locust, the centers to manage this, to monitor this locust swarms attack and all those things. So first statement is wrong. Positive Indian Ocean Dipole is one of the reasons for the locust attack. This can be explained because, so whenever there is good positive Indian Ocean Dipole, then there will be more amount of rainfall in the African Mascarenic High and African region. Okay. This is Asia, this is Africa. Whenever positive ocean dipole is there, so the winds will blow towards this continent and they will bring excessive rainfall. So because of excessive rainfall, the locust replicate like anything. Okay. This rainfall promotes greenery. Greenery promotes locust swarm production. So these swarms migrated from this Africa to the Asia. So positive Indian dipole is one of the reasons for locust attack is the correct explanation, correct statement. Hence, an answer is option B. Okay, this thing explains. So Eastern Africa, moist African deserts precipitated locust breeding and favorite rain bearing winds aided their transport towards India. So that is the explanation. So here option B is the right answer. Next question is about right to freedom of religion in the Constitution of India. So which of the following are not included? So first is freedom of conscience and right to practice and propagate religion is Article 25, which is correct. Okay. which comes under Article 25, which is correct. Collection of tax for the maintenance of any religion, it is not there in the constitution. So it is not there. Actually, Article 27 says that state should not spend the public money collected by way of tax for promotion or maintenance of any particular religion. So the second statement is wrong. Next is right to establish and maintain institutions for religious and charitable purposes. Okay, it is actually there in Article 26 of the Constitution. So it is there. It is a part of the right to freedom of religion. Next, importing religious instruction in any government maintained institutions is wrong. So as per Article 28, no religious instruction should be given in government institutions. Okay, so therefore here this is Article 27. Okay, so therefore 2 and 3 are not included under right to freedom of religion. So the question has asked about only which are not included, right? So therefore answer for 98 question is option C, whereas first and 3 are there in the constitution. Next question is about Persian Gulf. So Persian Gulf is a border of which of the following countries? So this blue region, I mean, if you are, this is all the Persian Gulf. So the countries bordering this Persian Gulf are Iran. So Iran is there. Even Iraq is there. Israel is not there. Saudi Arabia, this is Saudi Arabia. Yes, Saudi is there. And Qatar, okay. This is Qatar. Qatar is also there. So we can eliminate Israel and we include all the other things. So 1, 2, 4, 5 is correct. Hence, the answer is option B. Okay, even Oman is also there. So everything about West Asia, the map-based questions regarding West Asia and Africa are very important. Okay, next question is about BCG vaccine. BCG is what? BCG is Bacillus Calmette Guerin. So it is a vaccine developed to prevent the tuberculosis and leprosy infections in human beings. Okay, this is given immediately after birth. This is a live vaccine, an intradermal vaccine. So it is mainly, I mean, it is to treat tuberculosis as well as leprosy. Okay, so they I mean, earlier it was a thing that, so it was told that, it was told that, it was studied that, so people who were vaccinated with BCG vaccines got less damage, so they are protected against COVID virus. They got some immunity against this COVID virus. So this was a perception, this was a hypothesis, this is not yet proven. Okay, so in this this is just a what you call assumption. Okay, in some studies it was found like that, but it is the proof, I mean, it was not proved. So here BCG vaccine is against tuberculosis or leprosy. So hence answer is option C. Okay friends, with this we have completed the entire test of current affairs test number 8. Actually most of these questions are framed in the aftermath of COVID-19. The current affairs are taken especially from the month of June this year. So that's why in the month of June, everything is related to COVID. Any political issue, any social issue, any economic issue, any international issue, all are related to the COVID only. So that's why there is many questions regarding COVID, and there is overlapping of questions also. All the intention is to make you prepared for the main exam, that is the prelims examination, which is going to be conducted in the October month. So already I think hall tickets have been uploaded, so there will be definitely an exam, prelims exam. So you be prepared for this exam. In this test, actually I have intentionally covered the questions with a more vertical speed, with more speed, so that I can save time, so that you can also save time and you can focus on the static part as well as the current affairs issues. So it is actually a revision time, so more focus on revision, thoroughly revise all the material you have already gone through. So all the best guys, take care of your health, stay safe and stay focused.